Windows 11 now comes with a built-in screen recorder, and it's actually pretty good. You can record your screen and camera, just your camera or just your screen. And not only that, but you also get a full set of editing tools. It's completely free, and it also comes pre-installed. Let's check this out. To use this screen recorder, go down to your Start menu and then search for ClipChamp. This app is pre-installed and included by default with the latest Windows 11 update. If you don't have it, you can still get it through the Microsoft Store and you can install it there. Or alternatively, you can also go to clipchamp.com and then you can use it entirely on the web. On the main ClipChamp screen, here you'll see the option to record your screen and camera, just your camera or just your screen. For this, I want to record both my screen and my camera, so I'll click on this option. On the next screen, in the bottom left-hand corner, here I can see a preview of my camera. Who's that handsome guy there? I can also choose my microphone and I can choose my camera. And in the middle, this is a really, really cool feature. It's something called Speaker Coach, and you can either turn this on or off. If you turn it on, it'll listen to you as you speak, and it'll give you feedback on your speech. It'll tell you if you use filler words, what your pace is like, what your intonation is like. Ultimately, it'll help you become a better speaker. You'll also find similar functionality within Microsoft PowerPoint under the Slideshow tab. Down below, you'll also see that you're limited to 30 minutes of recording for this segment, but you can record any number of segments. To start your screen recording, simply click on the big red button. Next, I can choose what I want to record. I can record my entire desktop, or I can choose a specific window. I'll choose a window. And this now kicks off my recording. Here, I can see what I'm recording, and I can also see my camera. Down below, I can also see how much time has elapsed. Once I'm all done with my recording, I'll click on this stop button. Once you're all done, you can preview what your recording looks like. You also have the option to retake, and that's something I use all the time. Here, you could also review your speaker feedback, and last, you can also save and edit. Let's click on save and edit. This now drops us in the main ClipChamp editing experience. In the top left-hand corner, I can see all of my media. And one of the really neat things is when I record my camera and my screen, it records both of these separately. So I have one file for my camera and one file for my screen recording. Over in the top right-hand corner, I can see that it also saved these two clips directly to my computer. So if I want to use these elsewhere, well, I can do that. Here in the center of the screen, I can preview what my screen recording and camera look like. Within the preview area, right here, I have all of these different playback controls. So here I can click on the play button and I can preview what it looks like. Here, I'll pause again. Within the preview area, I can click on any of the elements on the screen. So here, for example, I'll click on my camera. And maybe I want to move this over to the right-hand side. Here, I can do that. I can also adjust the size of the camera. Maybe I want to make it just a little bit bigger. When I click on it too, I see these different controls, and maybe I want to crop the sides. I just want it to focus on me, so I could crop the left side, and then I could crop the right side. Also, when I click on this, over on the right-hand side, I have all of these different properties. I could adjust things like the volume, I could apply different filters, or I could adjust the colors, and some other options as well. Down at the very bottom, I have my timeline, and this is very similar to other video editing software. Here, I could trim the beginning of the clip. I'll click on this handle and I could drag it forward. Now, of course, when I do that, it leaves this gap there. I can hover over that and then I can click on this delete icon and that'll clear out the gap. Now, alternatively, I'll go to the end of my clip and let's say I want to remove the end. Here, I'll place my playhead right here. And I have these various controls. Here, there's one for split. When I hover over it, I can also press the S key to split. I'll press the icon and that splits the clip right at that point. I could select the end portion and then I could delete that. Now, let's say in the middle of my clip. For most of it, I have my screen recording and the camera in the bottom right-hand corner. But for this middle portion, maybe I want to have my camera use up the entire screen. Here, I'll go to the middle and I'll press the S key to split. And maybe right at about here, I'll split again. I can now click on this clip and I'll expand my camera to use up the full screen. Now, when I play it, here you'll see the standard screen recording. Then my camera jumps to use the full screen and here it goes back to the corner. So you could pull off things like that very easily. When I played the preview, it was just a hard cut between the full screen recording and then my camera. Over on the left-hand side, I can also apply a transition. And when I click on that, I have all of these different transition options. If I hover over any one of these options, it'll play a preview of what it looks like. Now, down at the very bottom, I think this one called TV interference looks good. I'll drag and drop that onto the transition point, and that now applies it to my timeline. Now, when I play the clip, here I can see the transition, and I think that looks good. Beyond just transitions, over on the left-hand side, I can also insert music, stock video, text, and even graphics. When I click on graphics at the very bottom, I see a category for stickers. And when I click on that, I can now search for stickers to insert into my project. I'll type in arrow. Here, I can now drag and drop that onto my timeline. Just like we did with the video clip, here I can trim how long that arrow should appear for. Now, this is really nice for a screen recording, especially if you want to point something out. And here I can click on the preview area up above, and I can change where that arrow is pointing as part of my project. Also, over on the left-hand side, I can click on this plus icon, and then I can bring in additional media from my computer. Right underneath that, there's the option to record and create. And when I click on that, here once again, I can pull in additional screen recording and camera segments into my project. Once I'm all done with my screen recording, in the top right-hand corner, I can click on export. And currently, 1080p is the best quality level that I can export at. Hopefully we see 4K come soon. I'll click on 1080p, and this now starts rendering my video. Here, I can click on the title and I can give it a name. Once it's all done rendering, it'll save this to my computer. Down below, I could also very quickly share it with various services. And here, I could very quickly click on create a link if I want to share this video out with others. All right, well, that's how easy it is to record both your screen and your camera on Windows 11. And it comes pre-installed and it's free. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.